want to tell you about my niece's wedding. It was a last Saturday, a fantastic day and all that. Had the wedding, told me about that, and also at the reception. It's held at the Golf Club in Goldfish. What a beautiful place that was. And it's a beautiful, nice place. You know what I'm going to put in when it comes to the lawn? They love the lawn and the big houses. It's funny. It's not what it says, it's not what it else. But it's one of those perfect gardens. The really funny house at Goldfish Spa Golf Club. We got there, we had this photographer guy. Actually, did my nephew's wedding just a few weeks ago. And he does a good job of really pushing the edges out of the way. Except, please don't use a flash. In the church, because I was taking the photographs of the church, and says, oh, I was using a flash, and he wasn't, and he came over and said to my turn, and he flashed in quite a nice way. But are all those wedding photographers on it? I suppose they have to be. I don't know. So, I mean, you've got all these loads and loads of people who've got to tell them what to do. You know, people are like, to move over here. They have 10 minutes later when I start moving. So, I don't know. Maybe that's a photographer thing. But I do find it really pushy. I know my niece's dad, my brother, called Martin. So we have the photographs done and then we will be inside for the bin. We will be inside for some drinks, orange juice and bugs fizz. There was a bloke serving the orange juice and all that. And I said, I've got the water. No, don't drink water, you've got to go down to the bar. And I thought he was a little bit rude. Whether he was had a bad day or something like that, and that's how he spoke to me. He said, oh, I'm sorry, sir, you have to go to the bar. This is the way to talk to me. It was, don't drink water, you'll have to go to the bar downstairs. And he carried on serving someone else. I thought he was a bit rude. So we had a little drink down there, and after that, we went into the hall for the meal. Now, my sister had done the hall up. Obviously, with her daughter, my niece, and a few other helpers. Unbelievable, right? That's all I can say. It was unbelievable. When I went in there, so I thought someone professional had done it. It was absolutely amazing. Instead of flowers on each table, they had these big feather things in different colours. Of course, my baby has come along. She even died on me. I saw these feathers immediately and started playing with me, like dropping on his head and that sort of thing. Most disturbing, really. Very, very disturbing. So, there was that. There were little sweets on all the tables, which again I found was marvellous, because you had their names on it, Tracey and Ben. That's the answer. And just so many little touches like that they thought of and done. All the chairs were covered in like white sort of covers on the chairs, and it wasn't bright in there either, and it was quite dim. And that added to the atmosphere, the ambience of the whole thing. Really, really nice. My niece did nothing but laugh all the time. She just kept breaking into laughter. Mind you, her new husband, Ben, must be like that as well. Mr. and Mrs. Clifford, they're now covers. Oh, Mr. and Mrs. I wonder how much they find out about each other over the years. You know, you see that program used to have all of you on in the UK, Mr. and Mrs. Did you know that one? Tell them where you are, and it's basically about, you know, couples that have been together over a short period of time or a long period of time, and they ask questions about each other. Do you know all about your partner? Maybe I know some secrets about your other half, perhaps. Have a what? Oh, please, it's a family show. Don't even go there. So the meal started. There was a choice of meals. I think, I've given up meat weeks ago now. I had already chosen the roast beef, so that's what I had, with vegetables and potatoes, very well cooked, well served. The people serving the food were very pleasant. Honestly, you could not fault this wedding reception. It was so good. It was so good. Really was. No fault at all with that wedding reception. After that, we had the speeches. Martin my brother-in-law, he started off with some troops, which I'm not quite sure why people do this, but he kind of put two forks, stuck one fork in another one and put a tissue up in front of it and pretended that the fork was, I don't know what all that was about. I don't. And then I think it was Ben's dad, who was also Ben's best man, he did some speeches and, you know, the usual supposedly funny best man speeches that people do their best at, but you sort of sit there thinking, oh, come on, let's get on with the tape cutting. Ben did some speeches to my nieces and her husband, that all went well. And what did I have for pudding? I can't even remember what I had for pudding now, but it was really, really delicious. It's rather unusual. They had some goldfish on the top table. Bowls of goldfish. I suppose if you were cooked with a little bit more package than that goldfish could be. Goldfish in a roll, possibly. And I did ask my sister what she's doing with those, and she said she'd take them back to her pond afterwards because they've got a big pond to go and put them up in there because the goldfish would become calm. They had another section in the hall full of cakes. Cakes that you buy from a baker's, you know, donuts, scones, things like that. It was all very nice. You could just help yourself to that after you make milk. And on another table, they had what they called a sweet corner. This corner of it was just full of seeds, all sorts of little things. You know, the Coca-Cola bottles, and the white mice, things like that. Bits of chocolate, chewing things on sticks, the whole table. And that was really nice as well. Although, my nephew Gary did take the biscuit a little bit when he went over at the end of it and filled up an entire carry an entire carry bag of sweets. I don't think my sister was too impressed with that. But on the other hand, I don't know what else she was going to do with them. Well, she also had something I have a weakness for, a great big jar of fudge. Oh, I do like a bit of fudge, so that was very nice. And so it went on into the evening, and there was a disco and a band, and I thought the band and the disco were very good. Both of the band were only in top of the band. Some of the older people were complaining it was too loud, but then, you know, I'm afraid older people always do complain that something's too loud, when it's like really a normal volume. I actually disappeared to my hotel room for about an hour because I was really tired and I had my head down for an hour and came back. When I came back, I think it was one of my aunts said, oh, it's a bit loud. When I went in, I thought, well, it's not really loud. You know, it's just one of those things, unfortunately. You will always have people complain that the music's too loud wherever you are. I thought they were good. I thought they were really talented band. They were doing cover versions of different things, you know. DJ again. For the DJ, he just played it. When you're doing a wedding or some other family occasion like that, you should just play the hits. It's a little bit of advice for people to think about starting DJing. Never start playing new stuff that no one knows at a wedding. Stick to stuff that has been in the charts and go back through the years, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, and you won't go wrong. And if all else fails, pull out Michael Jackson records. They never fail. Michael Jackson records never fail. So as I say, you know, if you're going to do that wedding or something like that, always stick to these. Alright? And then that was the end, really. And I had some more food come out at sort of about 10:30 at night on another table. That was really nice. I took a liking to those bits of pizza, which were, I have to say, the best little bits of pizzas I ever had. Really, really nice. We were talking to the other guests in there. There was a lot of RAF boys in there that my best mate Ron was straight over trying to chat to them for the entire time. It was embarrassing, really. You know, you might fancy it, but it is a meeting. The beer has calmed down a little bit. Although some of them were particularly gorgeous, I have to say. No, I didn't get any luck either. And that's really, that was the wedding. That was a great day was had by all. Went back to the room about 1 o'clock. I think I watched telly for about an hour, and then I slept like that. I went straight out and slept until 9:45 in the morning when I got a phone call from my cousin Susan, who said, are you coming down for breakfast? It's only 15 more minutes. So I woke up right in the bed next to me. and we rushed downstairs and had the breakfast. And shortly after, went home, went back to my sister's office, and she said, we'll take some sweets over this and the other. And that was it. So a wonderful, wonderful day at the wedding. Really nice. And congratulations to Tracey and Ben. And may they live happily ever after with the wedding bliss, along with my other, my nephew Gary, and his new wife Stacey. Got married a few months earlier, and they have happy years and lived together forever. Amen. That's it for the show today. Now, on the next show, we've got a load of emails to get through that have been building up over the last few shows. Well, that's a bit of a great show. Thanks for watching and listening. My email address is chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. We're in the garden today, actually. I've been enjoying a bit of my background of flowers around me. Best way to subscribe to the program is go to my YouTube channel and hit the subscribe button. Okay, my YouTube channel is Chris Reardon. Okay, YouTube channel, Chris Reardon. Thanks for watching and listening. See you on the next show. Bye bye.